guys, what's going on? We are loaded up. We are just about to pull up to Extreme here. You saw in the last video, last weekend when we got out, car is running great. As far as motor-wise and the way the car performed, I got on the track and time, you saw we hit personal best on everything. Other than the 60, which was still good, but didn't break any records. But everything else ran good. Like I said, I had a personal best out there. The problem is, we went out there with the goal of, you know, shifnoid working, improving on 60 foot, you know, doing a couple other things. So in that essence, we failed at everything. You saw the shifnoid did actually shift. I don't know why it hit the rev limiter. I'm thinking what it is that the RPM where I was shifting, I think it was at 76. It just, by the time it shifted, you know, it's zinging up so fast, it was able to hit the rev limiter before it actually made the shift of the car. But it did shift. Now, when I got home and tried it, it wasn't shifting. So we remedied that, put it up in the air, dropped the RPM, did all that, went through it, tried a couple times, two, three times, it worked. So I'll probably get out here again, put it up in the air, lower it down, just to make sure that it's not something funky in the software that's doing it. So that's really what I'm here today to do, is to make sure that the shifnoid's working. And again, try to get another personal best. We got a race we're going to next weekend, which we'll need to slow the car down just a little bit because it's got a calf on it, but it's the winter blast. So like I said, main goal is to get out here tonight, get the shifnoid to work, get the car set in. If we can run a number, great. If we hit it right off the trailer, if we hit it pretty quick, then we'll dial it in back to where we need to run for next weekend, because this is our last shot as far as testing. Only difference is it's like 80 degrees right now. And I think it's only supposed to be a high in the low or mid 50s next weekend. We're supposed to have a big cold front move in. So obviously DA and air is going to be a little different, but I don't think it's going to be enough to mess up what we're doing. Last weekend was super nice. And if it gets, you know, we're out here at dark and it starts to drop a little bit. I mean, the air's dry. So anyway, all that aside, like I said, we're coming out here and see if we can get the shifnoid to work, get this thing lined out, get it dialed in just a little bit more for the race next weekend. So we're going to pull up here, get checked in. We'll catch up with you here in just a second. Alright guys, just do a little bit of check on where I've got everything. I think I'm going to drop the shift point just a little bit, just because I'm not real confident in it shifting in time not to hit the rev limiter. I think I'm going to set it at 72. I'm just worried that it won't drop down past 72, which it should, even if it shifts to 75.
His dropped 1,000.
Well, this one usually drops, usually the higher the RPM, like if I shift at like 76 or 77, it drops to like 68. But the lower I shift, the less it drops, if that makes sense. Like if I shift to 72, it still drops to like 68. So I don't want to be too low that I don't come past it, but I'll put this, I'm gonna try to get to where it comes off. All right, let's go 71, 75, where it turns back off. All right guys, here we go. First pass.
Thank you.
track ain't there yet.
It ain't?
No. Oh. That was less than we left last time.
Really?
Yeah. It looked last time, it tried.
I figured you left it the same as last time, and that's why I did that.
No, it's about 100 RPMs lower. It's just not there.
Did it break loose out here?
No.
No? It sounded like it.
No, I ran it out.
Yeah, no, it
just
sounded,
to make sure the
sounded
ship
like some tires broke loose.
Yeah, I just ran out to make sure the ship door was working. So
it worked?
Yeah, it worked.
It worked?
Yeah. So now if I get offline, I know I'm just freaking mad and go.
Right. Sweet. There you have it, folks.
Prep here in about 10 minutes, so we're gonna go ahead and hop in the car, head up there, try to make another pass. Sun's gone down, it's gotten cooler, DA dropped a little bit. I'm debating on whether to change. It didn't hook last time, but the prep wasn't very good. And I'm kind of like, I need to make a pass, leave it the same, or do I try to make a run? I'm leaning more towards just leave it the same. If they're gonna be prep, I'll try to be up there first in line. But let me check tire pressure, do a little up there, and see what happens. You can see here what I've got. This is where I knocked the tires off right here. I'm back in it. It's pulling hard. For whatever reason, it will not get that first shift. It's all the way in right here. And smacks the rev limiter. I've got it set at 72. Which I go to this shift here, it shifts. It went to 4458, so about 200 RPMs passed, and then shifted fine. And then rolled out the rest fine. So I don't know, for whatever reason, why it's missing that first shift. That doesn't make any sense. We left on 6 pounds of boost, but it does not like first gear shift for some reason. And I could say, well, I could just shift first gear by hand and then let it shift itself after that, but what's the point of having the shift noid if that's what it's doing? I don't know. Comment down below if y'all know any ideas of why it would do that just on the first. I could see if it was spinning and it would just go past and hit it, but we weren't spinning. It was just, for whatever reason, that was it.